I spent 24 years in the military, and we are starting to have our own streets just as bad, if not worse, than the streets that we patrol in Baghdad and in the Hindu Kush of Afghanistan. Over the course of literally a month and 2 days, we have lost 73 lives and 227 citizens are wounded. These are children. These are people that were going to church. These are people that were shopping in a store. People going to school. I wish to God that I was allowed to come on here and post pictures that I have and all kinds of soldiers have to show the real carnage of what goes on in combat and what it looks like to be hit with a 7.62 right in the friggin' face or in the chest so people could see. And instead of thinking, wow, look at that, that's the Al-Qaeda, you would think, is that what it looks like for a child to have a hole in their friggin' rib cage where you could stick your fist through or their complete friggin' face split in two? Because that's what's going on in the United States of America. And I'm asking for veterans to get off your get off your asses and start friggin' being heard. Go to your friggin' legislators and tell them that they got to fucking do something. We did not serve this country so that friggin' people could die in the streets. 78 people killed in 1 month. In 1 month. That sounds like Iraq in 2004. But it's in the United States of America because we don't have no friggin' legislators that's got the friggin' balls to stand up to NRA. Right there, NRA. Right there. You have to understand, I own a pistol. I own a shotgun. But my God, we've got to come to the table. We've got to come to the table and sit down with these people that are responsible gun owners. Come to the table and sit down with people. And let's come up with some plans to keep guns out of the hands of these jackasses that are walking into our Walmarts, that are walking into our churches, that are walking into our schools, that are busting out the windows over top of concerts and just mowing people down in the United States of America. You all claim that you want to carry a gun so you can protect yourself? Ain't nobody protecting shit in this country. Our citizens are dying. They're dying everywhere. And you guys, half you friggin' people ain't never know what it's even like to squeeze a goddamn trigger. But you want to talk a game. You want to talk a tough game. If you've seen what it really did, the carnage that comes from it, then maybe you wouldn't be so quick to want to walk around carrying a friggin' pistol. And these people out there that are on these websites where they're pushing this racist bullshit. I'm so sick and tired of you son of a bitches out there talking about all these people that are Mexican and how racist this country is. I don't see black people out there mowing people down left and right. I don't see mass shootings coming from the Mexican people out there. It's coming from these white supremacists, what it's coming from. We have a hatred in this country. And it is being fueled by the top. But my God, ladies and gentlemen, something's got to stop. And I could give a shit about the NRA. All these legislators out there that are supposed to be out there standing up and fighting for people. You're too chicken shit. You're too chicken shit to stand up to the NRA. You cowards. This is really hard because we got people that are dying and nobody has the balls to friggin' speak up. None of you. None of you. You know, think about that. We've got people that don't have children tonight. We got people that don't have children tonight because you fucking cowards don't have the guts to do right by this country and the people inside it. I hope every one of you burn in hell. Sappers, clear the way, airborne all the way.